Kia ora. Joining me today are Marae Māori media commentators and political analysts and winners of the Talkback Hosts of the Year in the New Zealand Radio Awards. Congratulations, JT and Willie Jackson.
Kia ora, Jay.
Awesome. Why do you think you guys actually won the award?
Good looking. very clever.
It's been hard because I've been carrying them for a few years now, you know, but we got there.
Oh, congratulations and happy birthday.
Yes, thanks very much.
Okay,
just turned 40.
Yeah. Willie, now you absolutely attacked Hekia Parata on your show, saying that she was using her Māori heritage to political gain. Have you apologised to her yet?
Is that my Māori TV show on Friday nights at 10 o'clock?
I don't know.
Yeah, no. I don't know if I really attacked her. I think she expected the questions. No, I won't apologise to Hekia. It goes with the territory when you front up on this sort of kaupapa. And, hey, I think she handled herself very well. And she continues to do that, but I won't resolve from the fact that I think she's being used by the government, and she's the right type of person to front for the government, because who better to do your own over than your own? So,
how do you see it, JT?
You know. Oh no, I think Key is extraordinarily good at picking the right horse for the right course. Mm. If you have a look at Paula Bennett, part Māori, female, solo mother. Who better to run the welfare program, and who better to sort out beneficiaries? If you have a look at the difficulty in mining, who better to sort out Ngāti Porou and Whānauapuni than a person that's strongly whakapapas of the area and who's strongly pro-entrepreneurial innovation mining?
And they see her as the princess for Ngāti Porou. Mm.
Absolutely, so therefore I think that's why she's been so upset by some of the comments. I mean, as Māori we like to protest and hurl our opposition.
Yeah.
But saying horrible things like drill you up the...
Well, we don't talk like that. John and I would never talk like that. We can't help what protesters are saying. But what I will ask her is, why have you ignored your own people, her own uncles? Have opposed this. You know, Uncle Api Rana Mahuika, Uncle Amster Reedy, they're saying it's a violation of our culture, and she's just ignored all that.
Have you given her advice?
No, I haven't, because she'll never take it. But the problem you've got is there is a disconnection between what Greenpeace are up to and what Whanau Apanui and Ngāti Porou are up to.
Are you saying that because you have capitalist tendencies
Whanau Apanui and Ngāti Porou are saying this quite clearly. You are invading our sovereignty, and this is our kapatakai. This is our fruit bowl of the sea. And you've come in, there's been no consultation. Hekia accepts that. Jerry Brownlee accepts that. Key accepts that. What Greenpeace is saying is, thou shalt not drill, thou shalt not come into this area. No, what Māori is saying is, no, there is a range of protocols. We are the owners of here, and you've walked right over the top of us. Will we have a conversation with you? Yes, we will, but we're not going to have a conversation with a gun pointed at our head, granted to you by a government that run over the top of our rights. What Greenpeace is saying is totally different. And so you've got to be very careful about Greenpeace using Māori rights to advance their so-called
It's only right they sort of come together for that. John's right.
Absolutely.
But we come together on this because they've been rude to everyone. Right, but Māori have to be consulted. This is a violation of what we talk about in terms of the treaty, and we deserve consultation, not to be ignored. And Hekia has to be more accountable.
But what we're hearing so far is that Māori don't want to have the conversation. You know, are they denying, or are we denying ourselves business opportunities?
No. The issue that we've got here is quite clear, and that is that on behalf of all New Zealanders, as usual, Māori stopped asset sales through the courts, stopped it in the Waitangi Tribunal, and said, let's have a proper conversation, Kiwis, about what our rights are, how we're going to go into the future with these assets. And Māori should be applauded for having stopping this, to have this conversation on behalf of all New Zealanders about foreign ownership, foreign exploration rights, foreign transfers of dollars out of our country, and what we actually get back from it. So you can't sell your soul just for a couple of jobs.
This is obviously going to be the make or break for Hekia. How do you think she'll go? Will she sink or swim?
Oh, no, she'll swim. She's going well.
Are you saying that she will convince Māori to drill?
No. She won't convince Māori of anything, but all she has to do is do the job for her government. She's doing the job. She's well on the way to stardom, because, you know, the best way to to really do well is to sell your own out. And she's doing that very well. I mean, and there's just the fact. And as John said, there's two sets of Māori here. There's his son-in-law, Rawiri Waititi, and them, who actually, they all line up with Greenpeace. There's another group of Māori there who want consultation, who are interested in business opportunities. So JT's right in that area. But back to Hekia, this is the game she's in. And she's doing a great job for the Tories. They love it that she's dealing with her own. She's very strong. She's very articulate. She seems to have convinced herself that Petra Brash care about Indigenous people. She couldn't be further from
the truth. To do that. We've got about 30 seconds left, so I just want you two to confirm. Will you be standing for Hone Haruwita's party?
Oh, I'm happy that he's just renewed his marriage vows in Rarotonga. And I think he might.
Well, you know, you don't
Which
want
to be... one? Are you both going to do it, or is just one
moment,
of you?
At the moment, I don't know what on earth he's going on about. As you can see, he can never,
are you going to join Hone Haruwita's party?
Be a candidate. We're giving him advice at the moment. That's where it's at
you
the
haven't
moment.
Answered the question. Yes or
no?
No,
we're not.
He's
announcing his party candidacy at the end of... the party, I think, in a couple of weeks. We won't be part of that. So, obviously not.
Okay, well, thank you very
at
much, Willie Jackson. Oh, so you're going to change your mind again. Thank you for announcing that on my couch.
He's a flip-flop.
Kia ora, you two. Kia ora. Thanks.